Hey y'all, I'm just sitting here on this beautiful Saturday afternoon, sitting in my car. I'm about to go into a store here shortly, but I just felt compelled to jump on and just talk to you all for a second because I just got a call from one of my relatives and asked me some credit questions. So I just felt compelled to jump on here and kind of share some things with you all. So I know you all probably have heard me talk about, and even in other, kind of like credit repair groups, you probably heard people talk. Number one, when you have a collection count or a charge off or an account that you just want to pay off, you don't want to even dispute it, you just want to pay this account off. Well, the first thing is, number one is, if you pay an account off, always do a pay to delete. Okay, so it's really not going to have a bearing on your credit score if you just pay off a collection account. So you paying off a collection account, it does not have a bearing on your score opposed to if you did not pay it off. You always, when you do pay the collection account off, you always want to make sure that you get some type of pay to delete agreement. Okay, also, if you're paying off an account and you just want to pay off, you just feel compelled to pay off accounts, make sure that you start with the accounts that are within the first 24 months of them being put on your credit profile. So what I mean by the first 24 months, so today is June 13th. So you go back to June 13th of 2018, that's within the first 24 months. So you pay off anything first, because that has a bearing on your credit profile if it's within the first 24 months, opposed to if it's something that's been on your credit profile for, 3, 4, 5 years ago. So you always want to make sure that if you're going to pay stuff off, you want to do a pay to delete. You contact the data furnisher, whomever has the account. You ask them to do a pay to delete, okay? Then, say if you are just in a process of trying to build up your credit by getting a secure credit card. So maybe you can't get an unsecured credit card. Well, if you get a secure credit card, you also want to make sure that, number one, you keep your utilization down between 1% to 7%. No more than 10%, okay? I know back in the day, people used to say, okay, you want to keep your utilization down between, 30%. Well, guess what? That was back in the day. We found that you get the maximum amount of points now if you keep your utilization between 1% to 7%. I've tested the waters myself, and I can tell you that that does make a difference, okay? Also, you want to treat that secure card like it is it's a regular credit card. This is not a card. This is actually a credit builder card. So this is not a credit card that you're living off of. This credit card is just to help boost up your credit score, okay? So it's not a card that you want to run up, you want to charge up. So if you have a $300 secure card, you don't want to put no more than $30 on that card. You want to put accounts such as like Netflix, Hulu, Amazon Prime, or something small on that. And I do not suggest paying that bill all the way off. The reason why is because you need to have something to report to the credit bureaus. So you want to at least keep 1% on your credit report, on your credit, card, so that it can report to the credit bureaus. Because if you pay it off and it's at a $0 balance, there's nothing for the credit bureaus to report, okay? So if you also have and installment loans, they help. So such as like, I know here in the St. Louis, Missouri area, we have a bank that I recommend, a credit union. It's called the St. Louis Community Credit Union. So people can go there and get, it's called a Fresh Start, a Money Matters loan. So you can go get a Money Matters loan and you can pay like $54 a month. The reason why I like that is because the money goes back into your savings account. However, the goal is for you to be able to save. That's the goal. The goal is for you to be getting in the habit of changing your mindset. We got to start changing our mindset. Credit restoration starts with the mind first. That's where it starts with. You got to be able to begin to change your mindset, because if you don't change your mindset and you you know, clear up your credit profile, because we walk around with a credit profile and not a credit score. But if you clean up your credit profile and then everything's clear, but then months later, you back in the same rut, you got to start changing your mindset first. But back to the Money Matters loan. I recommend that you get a Money Matters loan. That helps with your credit mix, because you need to have 2 to 3 installment loans, okay? So you can start off with a Money Matters loan, any type of loan through the credit union or maybe your bank, or a fresh start loan. This is to help you get ahead. This is to help you rebuild. So then with the Money Matters loan here that I like with St. Louis Community Credit Union, if you get this loan, then you'll pay like $54 a month. Your monthly payments that you make, the money actually goes into a savings account. So the money can sit there for a whole year. It can build up. It's $600 loan. So the money actually sits there. Once the money sits there, then you're able to actually, you know, you can let it sit there for 6 months. I'm sorry, let it sit there for a year. But if, you know, things happen and you need to take the money out, you can take the money out. So those are a little credit tips today. That nothing major, nothing, you know, big or fancy, but just kind of wanted to jump on and tell you all that. So enjoy the rest of your Saturday. I know I'm looking a little rough. I know it. I'm still in quarantine. I'm a little hesitant about if I want to get my hair done, or if I want to get my my eyebrows arched, or if I want to get a pedicure. So I'm still quarantining right now. But I just wanted to tell you all that. Bye-bye.